Waka, welcome to Talk Business, and to all our viewers who are joining us from around the region via Sky Pacific, welcome to the show. Now, when it comes to fruits and vegetables, it doesn't get any fresher than what's available here in the Pacific. In fact, for many Pacific Island countries, agriculture is a stronghold, which is why on Talk Business tonight, we feature one of Tonga's largest producer and exporter of local fruits and vegetables. Join us as we take you through the entire process from the farm to the processing line. That's all coming up in the next half hour. If there's anything in the Pacific that we're extremely good at, then it has to be agricultural farming. Well, apart from whipping up delicious, authentic Pacific cuisine, but farming, though, has a special place since time immemorial. That's because our ancestors have always had a unique connection to the land, the whanua, as we say in the Itoke language, or whanua in Tongan. Subsistence farming lies at the very heart of Pacific cultures. It's our way of life, our heritage. But over the years, the need to survive has grown beyond our simple lives, and many have turned to what they know best. Enter commercial farming. And Nishi Trading, a family-owned Tongan business in Nuku'alofa, is an enterprise that has realized this potential. It started out as a dream for Minoru Nishi, the man behind the brand, and today it's grown into a well-respected export venture. You see, Nishi worked as an accountant for the Tongan government, but farming was always his passion. He was known for his green fingers. After all, his father, a Japanese immigrant, also had a long history with farming. Despite his day job, he would grow various fruits and vegetables and began exporting to New Zealand in the 1970s. He was also Tonga's first squash farmer and called the business Nishi Squash Exports then.
Grow yam, taro for local. That time, hardly any export to New Zealand or whoever, you know, the Pacific. No export at all, none. Only for local marketing and, you know, market and domestic use. Since then, I like farming.
But farming was a lot more than just passion for him. It was about giving back to the Tongan economy.
I decided that it's good for Tonga as a whole, for export, you know, to help the economy. And since then, every dollar I had from the export, I invest in the farming. I bought more tractors, more equipment.
Today, Nishi Trading exports to New Zealand, Korea, Japan, and will soon begin exports to China. Just under 30 farmers are supplying the company with produce. Pulu Ahokawa is one of the many. He mainly farms vegetables, but his specialty is watermelons. 30 years of experience has taught him a thing or two about farming. Why does he farm watermelons?
Fast money. Only 2 months to get the money. But I grow watermelon every month.
He has 20 acres of watermelons scattered across 10 farms. For farmers like him, being connected to a market is crucial.
Because they have a market in this area. See, in here, only local in Tongan, and then go to Samoa. But I like Nishi, you know, they have a market. Maybe I go talk about to grow the watermelon. Okay, it's an easy, you know, easy money.
So we aren't taking you to a farm and not getting our hands dirty, are we? Let's start with the watermelons.
The first step a farmer must do is to do the land preparation, slashing the weeds down, and sometimes they burn to make it more easy and faster. And then plowing 2-3 times. And then seeds. The soil is well prepared. And then it's ready to plant. What I have here with me is chicken manure as fertilizer. I had to put it down here and then you mix it with the soil. Here are seeds, and I'm gonna plant 2 seeds, each seed there. It's gonna take 5 to 7 days to emerge up, and take a month to flower, and then about 10 weeks, then you will harvest. So this watermelon, ready to harvest. It's take 10 weeks from the time we plant up to now. So it's ready to harvest, ready to export to the market.
Now let's take a look at another crop, squash. Squash belongs to the pumpkin family and looks and tastes just like a pumpkin. It's very popular in the States, South America, and in Asia. China is the world's largest producer of squash.
From the time you seedling, from the time you plant, to the time you harvest, it takes about 80 to 90 days to harvest, to get this fruit.
Now, Nishi Trading also specializes in butternut, also known as the winter squash. It has a sweet, nutty taste, similar to that of pumpkin.
Actually, it's not much different from planting the watermelon and the squash. It's pretty the same. After you prepare the soil well, and then you plant it directly, the seed. But in the butternut, in this case, it's a different method. We apply the plastic, and then we direct sow the seeds into a hole 2 feet between plants. So right here, it takes about 3 months to be harvested from the time you plant.
Now, on to the onions. Who knew we could actually grow such good onions here in the tropics? Nishi ran a few trials and it proved successful. They're hoping to export onions to Fiji soon. Potato farming is also a regular crop and is sold mainly to the domestic markets.
Placed in a row where we separate the rejects from the export grade produce. They get cleaned and checked. The next step of the process is to dip it into a solution to remove any of the bacteria. The next step is that it will dry. So from the drying process, after the drying process, Then it goes on the conveyor belt inside the packing area. The packing area is the food grade, insect protected, and from that it is graded into the different sizes, and those different sizes are packed into the crates. The crates weigh about 400 kilos, and we get up to 40 crates into a container.
Now, onto the squash.
Well, with the squash, it comes from the farm. It gets loaded into our hopper. It goes through the conveyor where it gets sorted. All of the rejects are discarded, and the export grade continues through the brush. So with the grading, we grade out any defects. We also remove any ones that are too small, less than 900 grams, which is the minimum for our market into Japan. Some of the defects include splits, any small permutations for disease, and also excessive dirt. Once it's passed through the grading, it goes into a cleaning process. So after the squash has been graded and all of the defects removed, it goes through a cleaning process. We're using brush cleaning to reduce the use of water. Once it's passed through the brushes, then it goes through the final quality control check before passing into the packhouse for packing.
And finally, the watermelons hit the processing line.
The watermelon comes off the farm. It gets cleaned, checked for quality. If there's any residual dirt, it gets wiped and then it gets dipped to kill any final bacteria.
Since its inception, Nishi Trading has grown from a small family business to a large national exporter in Tonga. It's a success story that has inspired many Tongans to enter business. To add to their accomplishments, the enterprise recently launched their state-of-the-art packhouse. On hand to do the honors was the Crown Prince of Tonga himself, Tupoutoa Ulukalala. Talk Business had the rare opportunity to have a sit-down chat with the Tongan royal himself. Equally passionate about agriculture and helping Tongans enter business, the Crown Prince said that farmers were a crucial element in the success of Tonga's exports.
They are the real, they are the backbone of our country, economic-wise, and also to thank the help from the SBC. And just generally, it's great. I mean, for me as a young man, I'm very proud to come from the country. Like Tonga, we're really growing, I think, from my own feelings. I think prosperity is very close to us because of the efforts of all of you, the Nishi and the SBC, the European Union, and also the farmers themselves.
Taking over the reins of Nishi Trading is Minoru Nishi Jr. Growing up in the squash farms, agriculture holds a special significance. Today, under his leadership, the business has largely mechanized its farming processes and has attained several international certifications as a stamp of quality. And helping the business attain these goals is the European Union-funded Increasing Agricultural Commodity Trade, or IACT, project. IACT has provided financial assistance towards the construction of this pack house, as well as helped the business achieve hazard analysis and critical control points, or HACCP certification, which ensures a system of preventative approaches towards food safety in the production process.
It's made a huge impact, and we couldn't have done it without their support. So it's set up a nice piece of infrastructure here, which is needed to meet, again, with HACCP. It'll open up more market opportunities for our exports to any market around the world.
Not only that, Nishi Trading is also the only Pacific enterprise to be certified under the Sea Container Hygiene System, following an audit by the Ministry of Primary Industries in New Zealand. It's these achievements that have set the bar for Pacific businesses.
With HACCP certification, Nishi Trading has potential to access other markets and a better price guaranteed for these products. I urge government, through the Ministry of Agriculture and Food, Fisheries and Forest, and the industry as a whole, to make good use of this pack house to acquire the right capacity and economy of scale.
Obviously, you need capacity of your staff, you need capacity in your equipment to be improved in order to meet the standards of the international market. And this has been done quite successfully in the framework of the project so far, in partnership with SBC.
Currently, just under 2,000 tons of fresh exports are shipped out of Nishi Trading every year. Now with the pack house, this can be easily doubled. And with more capacity and volume, there's even room for value adding.
What we want to do is mobilize more farmers to grow whatever crops that the market demands. We're doing a lot of R&D at the moment for processed goods. So at the moment, we're only doing fresh. The idea is hopefully we'll get support, additional support from donors to look at our equipment that we need for processing, adding value, because that's what I think is the future for us here in the Pacific. To mitigate some of the risks with fresh produce, transport is a problem, freight costs is a problem, but shelf life is a problem as well. So we can mitigate that by adding value. I think the potential is a lot more, and we want to be able to achieve this by this time next year. Hopefully we've got a plant in place.
It's a move that's fully supported by Tonga's Agriculture Ministry. Presently, agriculture contributes around 16% towards Tonga's GDP. With more businesses like Nishi Trading increasing their capacity, it's bound to have a multiplier effect on the island nation's economy.
We want to work together with the exporters to know their focus, and also with their the markets that they have secured. So that it, when we work with the, from there, then we can work closely with the farmers.
This particular business model guarantees farmers of an assured market and a better price. And all farmers need to do is to produce more and feed these enterprises, because these enterprises already have guaranteed markets overseas. And this model will work better or creates a win-win situation if the enterprise like Nisi Trading reward farmers with a better price. In that way, farm produce will continue coming into the back house.
For the European Union, it's also about building the capacities of businesses like Nisi Trading that in turn will assist those on the receiving end, farmers like Pulu Ahokava.
I am hoping that the enterprises directly supported through the projects will be able to maintain a position in the new markets that are open to them. In this way, they will be able to make a profit and reinvest their profit in order to further improve and further penetrate even new markets. As I said, I'm hoping to see when the posting will be over and I will go back probably to Europe, products from the Pacific on the shelves on my supermarket in Europe.
But to get to that sort of production, farmers in Tonga must realize their potential and move into large-scale farming.
Majority of our farmers who are growing mostly at the grassroots level are not trained farmers as such, that they did their formal education. So about 4 years ago, we started with our small group of farmers doing fortnightly meetings. And in those meetings, the objective was to share ideas, share knowledge, look at problems that different farmers had through the supply chain and how we can actually work together to help them.
Which is why Tonga's Agriculture Ministry is forming synergies with farmers and exporters to reach healthier levels of exports.
With the coming of this project with IACT, we would like to see more of this involvement of securing the market. From there we get the market the information, we can inform the growers the time for them to grow and when to harvest, so that we can make sure that the market is there for them when they need them.
Nisi Trading has also adopted a more proactive approach to help farmers understand the concept of farming. It's now in the process of setting up a training school to equip farmers to yield better harvest. They're hoping to engage farmers, students, women and those living with disabilities to learn and share the mechanics of farming, and in that process, cultivate the passion that already exists in farming.
We will help them in any way we can by potentially giving them land to do growing for the company. So the company will provide that for them and provide ongoing support, monitoring and evaluation on their crops, various crops that they'll be growing, and then supplying that to the company at a fixed price. So there's a guaranteed market for their produce, whether it's export or domestic. But we want to help that and help the capacity of that grow. So we want the farmers to be specialized in a particular crop and they can grow that. And as they get better and better at that, they become trainers for others in the community.
And that's the show for this week. We'd love to hear from you. So do send us an email, talkbusiness@fijitv.com.mj. Remember, you can catch me on the net on our YouTube channel as well as our Facebook page. And if you're on Twitter, follow me at @RachanaFijiTV. Thank you for joining us. Do join us again at the same time next week when we'll feature our final episode here from Tonga. Until then, have a productive week.